الحمد لله رب العالمين والصلاة والسلام على سيد المرسلين وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته once again. And inshallah ta'ala, you and your families are doing well and keeping safe, inshallah. I just wanted to remind again myself and all the listeners, inshallah, by way of trying to keep us motivated and encouraged, and to inshallah ta'ala keep the iman going, inshallah, and strong. And I thought about the idea when a calamity comes down, or a difficulty, or we lose somebody who is dear to us. We often, as believers, as Muslims, we often say "Inna lillahi wa inna ilayhi raji'un," which simply means we belong to Allah and we shall return to Him. And there is a nice anecdote, a nice story that I wanted to share with you today about one of the scholars and the Zuhad ascetics of the past, whose name is Al-Fudayl ibn Iyad. Al-Fudayl was, before he repented to Allah and became a scholar and a Zahid ascetic, he was in fact a thief before that, and then Allah gave him hidayah, guidance, and he became eventually a scholar. And so there is a nice encounter that happens between him and another man, and it goes like this. Al-Fudayl ibn Iyad, rahmatullah alayhi, said to a man, "Kam ata alayka?" Qala 60 sana. Al-Fudayl asked the man, "How many years have come upon you?" He's asking him essentially, "How old are you?" But they didn't ask this question in this way, "How old are you?" But ask, "How many years came upon you?" And the man responded, 60 years. Qala fa'anta mundu 60 sana tasiru ila rabbika. So Al-Fudayl ibn Iyad said to him, for the last 60 years, you have been moving forward towards your Lord. فَقَالَ الرَّجُلُ, the man said, إِنَّا لِلَّهِ وَإِنَّا إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُونَ. To Allah we belong, and to Him we return. فَقَالَ الْفُضَيْلُ, Al-Fudayl said to him in response to his statement, إِنَّا لِلَّهِ وَإِنَّا إِلَيْهِ رَاجِعُونَ, هَلْ تَعْرِفُ تَفْسِيرَ مَا تَقُولُ. He said, "Do you know the meaning of what you have just said?" And the man said, "I think I do, but please tell me." Al-Fudayl said to him, "It means this: Anta lillahi abd, you are a slave to Allah. Wa ilayhi raji', and he shall return to Him. Faman alima annahu lillahi abd, whosoever knows and is convinced that he or she are a slave to Allah, wa annahu ilayhi raji', and that he shall return to Allah one day, falyalam annahu mawquf, then this person needs to know that he will be stopped and questioned by Allah. وَمَنْ عَلِمَ أَنَّهُ مَوْقُوفٌ, and anyone knows that he or she will be stopped and questioned by Allah, فَلْيَعْلَمْ أَنَّهُ مَسْؤُولٌ, then they should also know that they are responsible. وَمَنْ عَلِمَ أَنَّهُ مَسْؤُولٌ فَلْيُعِدَّ لِلسُّؤَالِ جَوَابًا, and anyone who knows that they are responsible and will be questioned by Allah, then they need to prepare an answer for the question that Allah will pose to them. فَقَالَ الرَّجُلُ, in response, the man said, فَمَا الْحِيلَةُ, he said, "Oh my God, what do I do? How do I get ready?" قَالَ يَسِيرًا, he said, "Inshallah, it's easy, it's not that difficult." مَا هِيَ, the man said, "What is it? Well, how can I be ready?" قَالَ تُحْسِنُ فِي مَا بَقِيَ يُغْفَرُ لَكَ مَا مَضَى, that you do good in what is remaining of your life, and then Allah will forgive you that which passed. فَإِنْ أَسَأْتَ فِي مَا بَقِيَ أُخِذْتَ بِمَا مَضَى وَبِمَا بَقِي, but if you do bad in what is remaining of your life, then you will be taken into account for what you have done in the past and what is coming in the future. The point is this, my brothers and sisters, that definitely we shall return to Allah. And so really for believers, calamities or like the coronavirus, for example, is a wake-up call. Now, we don't wish this upon anybody. And as People of faith, we need to make dua day and night that Allah removes this and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brings a vaccine as soon as possible. But we cannot let this calamity or pandemic go unnoticed in as far as our consciousness about Allah is concerned. We need to be thinking about the return journey to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And the fact is, you know, death will come upon any one of us, anytime, whenever, however, we don't know. But the real issue is, have we prepared an answer when we stand before Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? And what will that answer be? And of course, part of that preparation is fulfilling the rights of Allah himself, but also fulfilling the rights of the creation of Allah. And that is why in these difficult times, as I have said repeatedly, we must demonstrate the highest and the most sterling of qualities. We must demonstrate the quality of giving and not taking, the quality of preferring others over ourselves who are in need, and not simply hoarding, but also looking after our neighbors, making sure our neighbors are safe, especially if they are elderly, and turn our houses into masjids, establish the 5-time salah, call adhan at home, call the iqama, and sit for a while with your family and remember Allah and talk about the real purpose of this life and the ultimate journey to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep you safe inshallah ta'ala and your families and all of us. And we ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to allow our scientists to come up with a vaccine for this pandemic as soon as possible. Jazakumullah khair. Wassalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi ta'ala wa barakatuh.